sort of instant disable with the stun against the Puck and Mewer. So overall, very good synergy heroes with the Chen and Shadowfin. I guess the laning phase might actually mean Shadowfin goes to the safe lane and DK goes mid, I think.
Could be. Arteezy does pick up the Shadow Fiend. Let's see. What do you think about the two drafts? Let's take a look. Take out the fact that Na'Vi is using a stand-in right now. Who do you think put together the best draft?
I think both sides have very similar drafts. They have a similar goal. Both have lineup. Peaks early, want to group up early to push down towers and have sort of decent late game. I would say Secret's late game is obviously a little better with Dragonite and Shadowfin, 2 damage DPS cost, and Na'Vi side we have only a Weaver, but we can't really look down on the Dazzle late game. Dazzle late game is also very strong. But early game, I would say both sides, it would be who does better in like team fights, because both sides have potential to win team fights early on, and it would be the first few fights that, you know, decide the momentum and pace of the game.
All right, let's do some quick introductions. For the Dire side, Team Secret, Arteezy is going to head out right away on the Shadow Fiend down into the offlane. We're going to have Puppy playing the Chen, S4 playing that Dragon Knight, Kuroki playing the Rubick, which is going to be a lot of fun to watch, I think, and Zai playing that Tusk.
And on the Radiant side, we have Na'Vi, we have Soneko playing the Dazzle, Hovos on his Weaver, Dandy on the Puck, and on the offlane we have the stand-in LT from Energy Pacemaker on the line. And lastly we have Funic on the Jack Hero. He just plays a ward to block off the cam here, so Secret won't be able. It's important to have this ward though against a Chen. You don't want a Chen to run over nearby the lane and have a good creep and pressure the lane. So this is a really good ward against the Chen.
It does look like Zai's pinging it out, saying, hey, they warded here, so they'll at least be working on getting around that. Arteezy goes to the high ground, finds himself Havos, and he's going to have to back away. Takes a nice shot from that Weaver right out of the gate, so he's a little bit low enough to start eating through that regen, but they do get the bounty rune. They also got the top.
Interesting lanes. They're going to lane Rubick plus Shadowfin on the offlane. Chen will probably be freestyle, do whatever he deems necessary to help top or bottom, so Tusk is on the safe lane, starting out with Boots, and he will be up against a Jack Hero 1v1.
Alright, we have a little bit of a slideshow. We'll keep an eye out for the next minute or two and see if we can have it go away before we go ahead and get that fixed. It's happened at the beginning of every game. Really frustrating. Alright, so Havos lines up with Soneko as they get ready to harass Kuroki and Arteezy. Gonna be a pretty good fight down here in this lane, already putting some damage on Kuroki. Arteezy taking a lot of hits as well. And now the pick up and throwback, and now it's the opposite side. Soneko in some trouble. He's got to fall back. He gets down to 68 HP and did not pick up the heal, so he's got to be pretty careful there as he falls away.
Yeah, he was lucky the Shadow Fiend didn't take race at level 1. Otherwise, that was first blood because he took poison. They did a lot of harass damage on the Shadow Fiend and the Rubick, though. That's like the good thing about that.
Yeah, it's Arteezy's actually already used all 4 tangos, and he's been in lane for about 1 minute.
And he's gonna have a really hard time here though. I don't think he'll be able to farm. So yeah, they're gonna move their lanes. I guess they'll rotate the Tusk bet towards bottom because they were probably anticipating that Na'Vi might have done aggro tri-lane with the heroes they had, Dazzle, Dirge, and Jack Hero.
So, Arteezy went with the Necromastery on the bottom lane, and now he looks like he's rotating out. So where is he headed to at this point?
He's going top for sure, because there's no way he can farm at bottom. The purpose of the lanes is they wanted the Shadow Fiend to get an easy lane to dodge the tri-lane. So they tried to lane him bottom, but that was where Na'Vi's tri-lane was, so he had to waste a lot of time to walk back to his top.
Alright, so let's talk about this middle matchup real quick. Dendi on the Puck versus S4 on the Dragon Knight. No money. Who's got the advantage? Well, actually, pause that for a second as Zai makes a rotation. Dendi does see it though and will fall back to safety, but the Ice Shards come in, just knocking backwards. So who has the advantage in this middle lane?
I think last hitting wise is probably almost even, but the difference maker would be when Puck is trying to roam at level 6, because when you get your call, you're going to get a TP score, you want to move around, you want to smoke and you want to gank. And Dragonite at that point has his dragon form, so what is he waiting for? He's waiting for the Puck to move away, try to gank the other lanes, and he's going to push your tier 1 tower. And hopefully he gets a better trade out of that if the gank of the Puck fails, and he's going to get either a lot of damage to your tier 1 or he takes the tier 1 trade out.
Alright, so that Dendi and S4 doing a lot of back and forth harassment here in the mid lane, both seeking to get to that 6th position first.
It should be fairly, I mean, even, or maybe the park should be having a little more lasses, I think, than the Dragonite at the start. But it wouldn't matter that much, I feel. So, because Dragonite is still able to get farm. I don't think he'll lose the CS battle too much.
Worth noting that Dire did deward the camp block that was put there by the Radiant, but Radiant's been doing a good job of standing in the camp and preventing it from spawning just with body blocks. So they've been on top of that and really trying to box out any functionality by Kuroki down here.
But if you look at the lanings right now, Na'Vi has a significant advantage due to the fact that Secret had to move their lanes because the lanes weren't as planned for them. So if you look at the end result, Jakiro having a lot of farm, he has 15 and 8. Shadowfiend, the suffering hero for that rotation, 7-0 right now. So things are looking good in the laning phase for Na'Vi.
Na'Vi definitely need to get off to a good start, and so far it seems like he's doing it.
It's gonna help them out.
Chen's coming in. It looks like they're going after LT as he tries to run for the secret, the side shop. Rotates her out, puts up the tombstone, picked up, thrown down. LT taking some damage, and he is going to get away. Nice play by Funnic to buy a little bit of space.
He had stick charges, and he got a two-man decay off, which gave him a lot of HP. So he's fine for now. And that means wasted time for the Chen. Didn't get a kill, but at the very least, he's helping the Shadow Fiend farm. Otherwise, the Shadow Fiend was under so much pressure from the lane.
Alright, meanwhile, down the bottom lane where the attack is on, Zai's got to fall back under an onslaught by Havost. And they will chase him all the way back to the tower. He gets very, very low, 90 HP. Pops the Tango and starts to head right back over to lane. Meanwhile, up on top, Arteezy under chase by Funnic. It'll be more harassed, but now they got to be careful because here comes Puppy again, doing a good job of farming up these creeps and staying in range to really harass LT back every time he tries to get aggressive.
They are really forced to have the Chen constantly help this lane because Rubick plus Shadow Fiend is having a very tough time against the dragon and the zombie.
Alright, so let's take a look at the bottom lane where Zai is 8-0 matched up against Havost, who's having a really great lane at 25-5, sitting at level 5 already.
This is a hard lane for the Tusk.
Yeah, it's a very hard lane.
I mean, at least he's getting level, so he's close to level 5, so top lane,
and
again,
engagement again. Throw up the tombstone, catch Funnic in the telekinesis, pick him up, throw him back, couple right clicks to finish the job. Can they do it? Look how low he is. 34
and
health.
Zombies.
Turnbacks goes in, zombies on the chase. Now it's Arteezy that could be in some trouble as they want to follow him into the jungle. He goes for the TP, in comes LT. They finish the job. That's the first blood. Arteezy gives it up, and Dazzle is the one who gets it.
Yeah, that was a really good rotation from Sonico. Even though he didn't have the grave, but he was there just to make sure everything was fine and even got a kill on the Shadow Fiend. That was a really good rotation from Sonico.
It's not over yet though, because here comes S4 with the Haste Rune from behind, catches LT, puts up the stun, right clip, Breath of Fire, and again a decay, but is it going to be enough? Nope, it is not. And down he goes to the poison. Rotation by Funnic, will he get there in time? He won't, that Haste Rune is just too strong. S4 living the Haste Dream, baby.
Yeah, what's new, Toffees?
What's new?
Let's solve it, another Haste Rune. What's new?
Man. It's one of those things where you wish you could type, you know? Just be like, ah. Hastern. Zed Dendi taking advantage of the time that S4 is gone, trying to get himself a little bit of farm. Gonna head down towards that bottom rune, regen rune for him. So, nice little get for him on that 6-minute rune as he heads towards the bottom lane. Are they thinking about trying to close off Zai? Zai is low.
He's probably gonna get a kill here.
He gets a good orb.
That's a good chance he might get a kill here. Because Zai is trying to get his level 6 here. He's trying to get the last few experience.
Shari comes out, there's the orb, easy peasy. Uses the dream coil, but guarantees the kill.
Yeah, I mean, it's hard to blame Zai though, because he was really close to level 6 there. He wanted to take the final few CS experience so he can actually go back and heal and TP back out with his ultimate so he can help his team.
Yeah, so he does get picked off. Unfortunate for him. Meanwhile, Arteezy's got a beautiful stack going on here in the jungle. He is trying to get himself back on track with the farm as he had a rough start comparative to where we've seen him in his last game tonight.
He had a really, really rough time being forced to move around and middle lane. Here we go.
Oh, here's the engagement. They want to go. Dendi in some trouble. Does the orb phase shift? Jumps away, but S4 saw it coming from a mile away. And now he turns, wants to go on Sonico, who has to run. Gets caught with the stun. The right clicks are there. The poison. Oh my goodness. Breathe fire, and that's the death of two. And an easy tower push for Secret. Not too shabby.
They got a solo kill?
Did they? What? Oh my goodness.
On Horus?
Wow, well played, Zai. I missed it completely. I was watching the middle push. I didn't think Zai had it in him to take out a Weaver solo, but sure did. Meanwhile, Funnik turns back around, wants to go for some rest. Yes. TP's come in. Tower in deny range. Creep's putting work in, but Funnik will go ahead and get the deny. Has been denied. So the tower goes down. They don't get the gold for it, but Secret already applying a lot of pressure to speed.
Suddenly, everything changed with the dragon form from the Dragonite. Took a tower, got a couple of kills, and things now going back to Secret's favor. They're going to catch Sonico here. Aisha's going to block him off.
Sonico is in some trouble. Oh, gets torched by S4. And they'll just go ahead and clean up the tombstone. Little decay, but not going to hurt anybody as they get rid of the zombies and continue with the aggression. Secret 5-2 after a good start by Na'Vi. Look at that spin. Secret now in control of the gold by about 2,000. It's a 3,500 gold swing in about a minute's time. XP on their side as well. And I will pull up that net worth. Look at the stack. Dragonite number one. Yeah, and the rest of the people.
He's going to get a really quick Shadow Blade this game. He's going to get a very quick. He has already enough for one piece of the equipment.
So, Tombstone giving away free down there on the bottom. And what is... So, the tower is down. S4 looking at getting that Shadow Blade up and quick. Where do they rotate? Does Secret just start pushing towers after this?
They're probably going to stop and get at least level 6 on a Chen first before they move again. So, because Chen was helping his team a lot, he was moving around, so he's not... Usually you see a Chen like maybe level 7 at this point of the time, but because Puppy was sacrificing his farm and experience just to make sure that the lanes... That's how Puppy plays Chen all the time. He prioritizes helping his team more than his own, you know, economical status.
Xylos, Habo's gonna go for the dive, pops the Saguchi, comes in, there's the roll, wants to go, Walrus Punch, tries to get the exchange, nice! He gets the TP away, Sonico does survive, but they lose the Weaver.
He gets another kill and he has his Claymore plus 700 gold, so the Shadow Blade will come in, I'd say next 3 minutes, 2 to 3 minutes, so it's gonna be a very, very early Shadow Blade, it's hard to deal with. Forcing the supports to get sentries here and there. I mean, this is gonna be a very influential Dragonite for the next after the next few minutes.
For what it's worth, Sonico did finish off the Tusk with his poison touch, but now Denny in some trouble, gets caught by S4, jaunts himself away, and S4 goes ahead and uses the ultimate, but does not come away with the kill.
He just managed to barely jaunt away because the stun wasn't enough for the AWP to end. So he can't join. So it's a little bit of misfortune for S4 because Dendi was playing so aggressive and he wanted to punish. So he wasted his dragon form, not gonna get a kill. He's not gonna be able to push any towers soon. And top lane.
Here we go. Looks like a possible engagement. Zai's gonna lead the charge. Nice ice bath, but it's not gonna matter because the snowball comes out. They get one puck already down. Zai has to get out of the macro fire, but he's gonna back away. Funnik thinking about chasing Kuroki very low as well. Liquid fire doing some work. Ice bath, and Zai may pay the price. He will go down, and Funnik somehow survives. Down comes the tombstone. They finish off the Rubik. Arteezy in some trouble as LT wants to make the chase, but he'll back away. Can't engage into that. Already threw down, but here comes S4. Sees LT, wants to take him down, gets up the stun, gets out the right click. He's lost his ultimate, but it's not going to matter. Down he goes, and it's a 4 for the price of 2, and another easy push for Secret.
Easy Shadow Blade. 11 minutes.
Oh, good lord. 11 minute Shadow Blade, gold lead at 4,000 now for Team Secret, and looks like they will not push that top lane. They're just going to rotate away, not take any risks. Down on the bottom, Kuroki getting some gold here, getting some levels, getting caught back up, and he just hit level 6, so that's going to be great for them.
He's going to get a free Shukuchi soon. Going to wait here until wait he sees Shukuchi. The Weaver. Yeah, wait for the Weaver to show up. Oops, they have other plans.
Uh-oh, that didn't work out. There they come in from the side. Make their move on him. He's slow. He's body blocked. He's locked in place. He's going to go down.
Yeah, Hobos knows what Kuroki was trying to do there. He knew he just popped level 6 and he wanted to get Shukuchi.
Behold!
That's all you need to see to know what happened.
Monster kill!
Yeah, but meanwhile, S4 gets his first Shadow Blade yank on the Dazzle in the jungle, so he's on a monster kill streak right now. And they're gonna proceed to push another tier 1 at bottom, I think. Not sure what they're gonna do now with the pickoff.
All right, so back. So while we were gone, you said S4 got another kill with that Shadow Blade?
Yeah, he got another kill on a support while moving in the jungle smoke. So that was his Shadow Blade revealed. And things are going to feel dicey now for the supports. They're going to be like, oh guys, we need a lot of sentries now.
Already at that level 2 ultimate, 11 compared to the rest of his opponent, sitting at 9. So feeling pretty good off the push, but here they come. S4 needs to fall back right now, being attacked by Havos. The rest of the team comes in. Nice Ice Shard to buy some space, and they will retreat. Shadowblade is popped, and no problem. They put in some damage, and then just slowly fade away. Meanwhile, up on top, Arteezy executing the farm and working through the split push. And yep, a Midas up on him.
He has his favorite item.
The Midas. Alright, so down the bottom, they are going to continue 4 for Secret.
Here we go, dude. Kuroki with Ice Puff. Totally forgot about that. Rubik with Ice Puff. It's something we haven't seen for a very, very long time.
I just love watching Kuroki play this hero. Arteezy falls back as Weaver transfers up to the top to stop the push.
It's like the dream game, you know? Where you pick Rubik and there's so many things to steal.
Just tons of fun, and I think that if I'm gonna keep track of that, it is this guy. Gold, by the way, almost up to 5,000 XP at 4, and the push will continue. Checking in on before we do that, let's see if the possible engagement. Nice ice path to Macro Fire just to put some damage out on S4. Tombstone's down, Zai goes in deep. Walrus punch on LT, he dies to the long range breathe fire, and the Shadow King transfer actually got the last hit. And this tower will go down, and they can keep the push going.
Radiant's bottom tower has fallen.
They can even go Rosh because Zai, he has picked up a Medallion. So, Medallion plus Shadow Fiend this early with Chen is easy Rosh on.
And that is also, well, let's see, the mech on the Chen, you said that Medallion, Shadow Blade. I mean, this is just starting to feel very lopsided.
Easy Rosh on if they want to do it.
And it does look like I thought they would, but no, they decided not worth it.
Yeah, they want to push the lanes first because top and middle were very close to their tier 1s. They didn't want to... I mean, they could have done Roshan, but they want to do Roshan without giving as much away towards Na'Vi. So they're going to take care of the lanes. They can do it anytime. You can see Puppy. He's just staying, like, farming the ancients. He knows what's
going
to happen.
They're going on Arteezy down Arteezy. The bottom. Get up the Dream Coil. Right clicks are there. Arteezy could be in some trouble here. Gigi is going to go down. Nice job picking him out. They're got some woods up, but
I think they popped the heal a little. I didn't see if the heal actually got on him. Like, did the Chen heal actually heal Arteezy before he died?
I don't think that it did.
Yes, he thought Arteezy was gonna be dead for sure, and he didn't want to waste his hand of God.
I think that's let's see, it is down. Now let's look at the dire warding right now. They have insane vision on this map.
It's really good because they were moving around, they smoke. Yep. The smoke before when you were disconnected, they got a pick off on support and they got a ward down as well.
Oh, so there's another Shadowblade S4, comes in on Funic, but taking some damage. Shot inside the Rubik Ice Path. Out comes Shallow Grave, will it be enough? Walrus punching in the air, force staff to safety, not quite. Down goes the Tombstone, but they don't even care. S4 just eats through it like it doesn't exist. Here comes Havos, coming in with the Suguchi, throws out the Swarm, but all it's going to do is be zoned back just a little bit. They get the kill, they're happy with it, and Secret fades away again.
Game is getting really hard for Na'Vi right now. They are not going to be in control of any team fights after, because they can't really contest Rosh after this. Secret can do it whenever they please, and with the Aegis, it's going to be difficult for, and Na'Vi will be forced to try and maybe speed push a little. It's difficult for them to take fights right now in the position they have, and even with the lineup they have, you are supposed to be able to take a fight against Secret.
I will say that right now, Secret at a 7,500 gold advantage, XP of over 4,000, and they're going to go into the Rosh Pit. It does look like Dragon Knight working on his BKB. Is that what's going to be next? And it's probably going to come pretty quickly. He's already sitting on 2,100 gold plus that Ogre Club.
Yeah, it's probably BKB. Some players like to get Silver Edge, but I think BKB is much more valuable this game for the Dragon Knight. Against the Puck and Jack Hero, so much spell damage.
Alright, impossible engagement here. They're gonna back off of the Roche. Here comes the jump in. Arteezy dropping fairly low. Fights in the pit. LT already taking a ton of damage. He's gonna go down to S4. Poison. Sineko goes down as well. Funny popped up in the air. He's in trouble. That's the triple. And back into Roche. They just leave Havost there. They leave Havost in the care of Puppy's Creeps and he runs away. They're not even bothered by it as they go in and go for the Roche. Comes back. Havost comes back. The Puppy Army takes after him. Caught the ice bath and finish. It's a 5-man wipe. What? Secret playing out of their mind. Na'Vi playing out of position. And Secret goes 18-8. Gold Lead's going to jump up to almost 10,000 after this Roche goes down. And I don't know. What do you do if you're Na'Vi?
I can imagine Kuroki having so much fun this game. It's so fun to be Rubick, and he landed a couple of really good ice baths there as well to secure his team the fight.
Wow.
It's like one of those moments. You pick Jakiro, but it seems like the opponent has more ice path than your Jakiro.
That's the worst. Frustrating. Alright, so now we do see the Invis Tusk is gonna, Zai's gonna head out in the scouting position. Kuroki not even giving him that big of a lead, just staying nice and close. S4 gonna go into lane, and here they come. Ice path down, finds LT, Walrus punch to the face. The counter ice path, but will it matter? Out comes the Shallow Grave, and now Zai may pay the price for overconfidence. He goes down. Dendi on the jaunt, wants to make the chase. They're going after Kuroki. Do they have a stun? They do. Dream Coil used. Kuroki will get caught with the ice path. He gets the triple, but Funic gets the wraparound. And they do lose
just,
two
just
heroes.
Just a little cocky. They were, because they were just confident. They
it's
were
a lot of
so
gold, though. It's a lot of gold to get away.
Yeah, I mean, it happens. You know, everyone makes mistakes, so they just were just too cocky there. They tried to kill. They saw Undying and they thought they could burst the Undying with Solar Crest plus Walrus Punch.
Now, for those of you who did join us late, we did see a big influx of viewers. You may not know, if you're here to watch Na'Vi, you'll notice Art Style not on the roster right now. LT is standing in for him. He's a support from the Energy Pacemaker crew. And apparently Art Style is having some visa issues and may not even be able to get here for the tournament. But we'll track that as it goes along. Mars did delay as long as they could, but this is just sort of the roster that Na'Vi is going to have to play with. And it started okay for them, Winter, and then it just sort of died a horrible fiery death. Speaking of a horrible fiery death, S4 pops a Shadow Blade and comes a hunting.
Just one scary dragon at 20 minutes with his good level.
It's insane. He's almost got his third level ulti. Look at that. 1, 2, 3. Down goes Funic. They're going to throw the snowball after LT. And they don't even bother chasing him. They're just going to take the tower. Dendi throws the orb for harassment purposes, but that's all it really is. S4 goes to the high ground. We see the phase shift jumps away. S4 now on the tower with a little bit of help from Arteezy. The damage is real. Look at S4 going deep. Look at that. He doesn't even care. He comes in, gets up the stun. Now he backs away, but he's still high. Dendi comes in, tries to get the silence out there, does, but then has to jump back to safety as no one can engage into Secret right now.
It's like he's walking into some stranger's house and casually saying hi. They can't do anything about it.
They can't do anything. It is brutal. We do see Arteezy TP away because why not go get the farm when you're this far ahead? TP's to the top, pushes back all the towers. One tier one down on Secret side of the map, as Na'Vi has been unable to really even cross the river in this game.
Just the map control though, with the lead Secret have, you snowball, you take the towers, you take the Roshan, it's just very difficult for Na'Vi. They were supposed to be able to fight, but because things went wrong, they gave away the Dragonite too many pickoffs, and the early Shadow Blade was like the biggest problem they had in the last couple, like the last 10 minutes. So he couldn't deal with it, and he got too many pickoffs, and resulting in like the snowball effect, all the towers going down, and Roshan going to Secret as well.
Now we do see a smoke rotation towards the top lane. They're gonna look to get a pick off on Zai. There's the blink in. Goes into the snowball to die.
Radiant's bottom tower has fallen.
Night is over.
Radiant's bottom tower is under attack. Dire's top tower is under attack.
Dazzle has fight.
Dire's top tower has fallen. Radiant's bottom tower has fallen.
Them to go to the high ground, working into the town.
another million years.
Dazzle! A healing hand!
Backing the sides is just not worth it, puts the damage.
You're safe. Repent. You're not done with me yet. Zap.
Silence. Here I am.
Dark Light is slain.
I weave your fate.
Oh my.
The age is Kuroki on the run, puppy is.
They used one buyback from the park, right? Faith. Yeah, do you see how he died? He S4 had the dragon tail clicked on him before he was jumping in. That's why when he jumped in, he got instant dragon tail. Yeah, that was tough for him. Then he's like, it's like you're so angry. What? What just happened?
Even
he just
with the buyback.
But at least they won the fight. Yeah. It was so dangerous as well because Rubick got the Dazzle Ultimate, so he had the Weave on his own team, the whole team.
Eye on the top lane, so they ended up a triple.
Regeneration!
13,000, it is now. Bit ridiculous as Dragonite has now picked up.
They need to be careful already. Like the last fight, they were just it was just like mainly the buyback. But like you mentioned, giving away kills like this is still really giving Na'Vi a lot of gold. And they're gonna find another Shadow Blade pick off here on the Undying.
Here comes the look, wrapping around. S4 is gonna find LT. The big snowball from hell.
Yeah, but he's like, if you are, let's say you're Fear Secret, you're the Dragonite running,
tough game.
Or you're
the
Tusk trying to snowball, the Undying will be the first target you want to kill because you don't want him to drop the Tombstone before anything, before the fight starts,
fight
so
right
you want to kill him first. Mm. That's why he's being like the main focus.
Radiant's top tower is under attack.
Let's go.
Was there with the Shadow Blade, makes the high.
I was under order.
A dazzle. Nice triple ice path, but.
And if you're Na'Vi, you won't want the Roche
to watch. Gold is still gonna stay in.
This is almost maximum timer, right? This is
1 minute and about 30 seconds.
Oh yeah, this is the half of the 3 minutes, yeah. The halfway point of the 3 minutes, so it's one
not,
and a half.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, it blinks to three until that last possible second, and then it tells us. Why they can't do numbers, I'll never understand.
So much better. Why not?
Nothing comes to mind. 11,000 gold is secret. On S4, is he?
And it's
Shadow Wave.
Or Staff Seneca's trying
to
stay relevant.
She built into a Chrysalis though. And I was actually expecting like AC so they can push easier with the minus armor. And it certainly helps against the minus armor that Na'Vi has, the Weaver and the Dazzle. Quite surprising though, I didn't expect the Chrysalis.
Alright, so Dendi is close to an Egg Scepter. He has got three of his four pieces, but he is difficult game for them, and immediately they're going to go ahead and smoke.
Yes!
Trying to, maybe a little...
Are they gonna, they can steal the Roshan. They have Madeline.
Okay. That's what they're going to do. Go in and steal the Roche. Nice play.
Dark light.
This is gonna be interesting.
They will now rotate towards
fallen to the radiant.
Zap! You're safe with me. My dazzle darkens.
This is lagging. No plans. Hey,
near.
Killing spree, double kill.
Ultimate LT's gonna be the first one to go down. Nice!
Hand of God!
Radiant's top tower is under attack.
Behold!
Gonna have to TP to safety. Meanwhile, up here we got...
Can't really blame Na'Vi though, because they are, when you're far behind, you need to do something special to actually come back into the game. And they lost three heroes. They lost two heroes past the Aegis. Yeah, but it's what they had to do.
Man,
they can't just give they can't just give the Aegis to Secret. And it's just they have no chance to defend against that.
By the way, that because did Na'Vi.
I think it doesn't really matter anymore after that, because even if it wasn't because of the DD, they would still lose the fight because they are far behind. They were trying to their best to get out after the rush, but they couldn't.
Hyperstone now up on the Shadow.
And they're leaving the AC towards RTZ
now on building into that as well.
The structures are fortified.
Yeah, they look like they might want to engage here. Going after RTZ, puts up a liquid fire.
Radiant's top tower has been denied.
Oh, I want right!
It's Kyle with the stun. Tombstone's gonna come out. Not gonna.
Radiant's top tower is under attack.
Grass throws up as much.
Behold!
Radiant's top barracks are under attack.
The GG comes out.
Victory.
In this game, definitely the Dragonite just. He just got off to a good start, I'd say.
Wow.
Like usually you don't see the Dragonite being so powerful that early on. It-